Hello, Cambly learners. It's me again, Cambly tutor Yuri. And today I'll be going over how you can better learn and use synonyms to improve your IELTS score. First, I guess it's important to clarify what a synonym is. A synonym is a word or a phrase that means exactly or nearly the same as another word. For example, a synonym or another word for big would be large. Large is a word that means exactly the same as big. Or, let's use another example. Shut could be used instead of the word close. Shut the door, close the door can be used interchangeably. Now, if you use synonyms for many common words in English, this is a great way to improve your IELTS score. Why, you may ask? Well, let's go through some of those reasons. Reason number one. It is one of the criteria that IELTS examiners are looking for. IELTS examiners are checking for this. They're looking to see whether students taking the test can effectively use a wide range of vocabulary with flexibility. This means that the examiners are looking to see whether you can use a wide range of various words rather than using the same words consistently. Using a variety of words demonstrates that you have a good grasp of English vocabulary. And this is something that examiners will look for in both your speaking and your writing. Of course, it doesn't help you to simply memorize many different synonyms and hope you use them correctly. Using these words in the right way and in the right context is going to be important. So ensure you practice this with your Cambly tutors. Practice learning countless new synonyms and practice using them in sentences in the midst of a conversation. Reason number two. Consider using synonyms to avoid repeating words. Using some of the same words consistently in your speaking or in your writing may be a good sign to the examiner that your range of vocabulary may not be as wide as is needed. So this is where learning more synonyms is an opportunity to avoid repeating words. Again, you and your tutor may notice that you occasionally use the same words in your writing or your speaking. And if this is the case, work with your tutor on various other words with the same or similar meaning that you could use instead. So, here's a simple example. You may use the word good as your go-to word to describe something you enjoyed or found positive. Now, if you were to go online and look up synonyms for the word good, you might find many other, more sophisticated words you could use instead, such as fascinating, engaging, wonderful, magical, interesting, making your sentences far more interesting, but also you don't repeat some words too much. So, please note, I'm not saying don't use the same words when you're speaking or in your writing, because sometimes this can be a really good way to emphasize a point. What I am saying is where you feel that there is another word that you could use that would enhance your answer or your sentence, then definitely consider using another word. Consider using a synonym. Reason number three. Consider replacing some words with synonyms because it improves the quality of your sentence or response. What do I mean by this? Well, let's say you were to use the word bad or not good in the following sentence. A high level of sugar in your diet is not good for your health, or a high level of sugar in your diet is bad for your health. The use of these words, not good or bad, is somewhat a beginner level and not as effective in describing what you might want. So what could we replace these words, not good or bad, with? Well, how about harmful or even dangerous? So let's try it with these new, more advanced words. A high level of sugar in your diet is harmful for your health. Now, doesn't that sound better? This is how learning synonyms is important, but also understanding the context of the question you're answering and how you're answering is important too. So this simple strategy can vastly improve your sentences in both your writing and your speaking. Your final point, ensure you use synonyms in context. Remember that while we may have words that mean the same as other words, using them in the correct context is important because some words go together and some words don't. So for example, if we were to describe someone who we find physically attractive, we would probably use the word beautiful for a woman and handsome for a man. Now, you could also describe a city as beautiful, but using the word handsome to describe a city doesn't work. This is what's meant by ensuring that you use the correct synonym in the correct context. And that's it for today. I hope this short video on the importance of synonyms has helped you. So be sure to speak with your Cambly tutor about synonyms and about learning many new synonyms, which you can use both in your speaking and your writing. And for those of you who are unfamiliar with Cambly, well, Cambly gives you instant access to friendly native speakers like me. You can take English lessons anytime, anywhere, right from your phone or your computer. So schedule your next lesson with me or any of our amazing tutors just using the link down below. Thank you so much for watching. That's it for me. Till next time.